I literally panicked. I was like, yikes. Hi, you guys. Welcome back to the Clean Beauty Code. I'm very excited for today because we're doing a makeup tutorial. And the makeup tutorial we're doing is my everyday makeup. I hope you're excited. It's going to be a good one. So, if you're excited for this video and more videos like this, then please like and subscribe. It's so helpful when people do that. And without further ado, let's jump in and get into my everyday makeup tutorial. All right, you guys, I'm ready to go. I have you closer to me so you can see what I'm doing. My hair's up so you can see what I'm doing. And I'm moisturized and ready to start the process. So I just wanna say, my brows are already done. My brows are already done because I do my eyebrows first. However, doing eyebrows can be like super complicated and annoying. And I know like from watching other people who do tutorials, they don't always have their like, they don't do their brows on camera. So if you want me to do my brows on camera, I can definitely do that for you. But just for all intents and purposes, she's good to go. We don't need this to be like a 45 minute tutorial. But I can tell you what I use. So for my brows, I do soap brows, and this is the soap I use. This is the Pear soap. It's a clear one. I use a spoolie. I spray it with a little bit of water or just a spray that I have. And then I go over, do people mind? Don't they know I'm doing a tutorial? And I go over it with a spoolie and then do my brows, let it sit. And then if I need to fill them in, which I don't always have to do, I'll go in with a, like a brow pencil. And this one's really good. I really like this. This is a PYT pencil. I really like this one. It's not too dark, so it like lets you kind of, I don't know, finagle how you want it to look, and it doesn't look super super heavy. Like, I'm not going to be looking Sandy Cohen from the OC, hella thick crazy brow. Like, that's not a thing. But if you don't want to do a soap brow, I have two brow gels that I have in front of me here. I have this Jason Wu one that's clear if you're looking for like a clear product, but you're like, I don't have time to do soap brows, which I understand. It's a little high maintenance and a little bit annoying sometimes. And then if you want something with a color, then this one's really good from Merit Beauty. I really like this one. It does a really good job, holds it in place, doesn't make your brows feel too pomade-y, but not super crunchy. It has like that perfect in between. I really like it, and it doesn't deposit, again, too much color, so you're not looking crazy Sharpie brow crazy girl. Like, it's not gonna be one of those things. This is really good. Okay, next. So next I'm just gonna go on and do my foundation. So the foundation I'm gonna use today is I'm gonna use the Merit Beauty one. Also, I have a mirror that I'm going to have in front of me, so if I'm looking down, you know what's up, you know why I'm looking down. Okay, so this is what it is. I wear the shade Buff in this. Now this contain, like, this is hard to open. In my review I did say, like, you just have to be aware of the fact that, like, it's a little bit tricky to open. So, like, if you open it upside down by accident because you're like pulling and tugging and trying to figure out which way to open because both sides look the same, some of the product can fall out, which is what happened to me. It was fine. I stuck it back in and I have same amount of product, so it's fine, but just a note. Blending this out with a Heavenly Luxe number 7 brush from It Cosmetics. I really like this to blend stuff out with. My skin just like freaked out. I don't know what happened. So I got breakouts like on my chin and around my mouth. Like, I have one mark here, which is really just pissing me off. Nothing's worse than like marks around your mouth because I feel like they're really noticeable. Or really, we just think they're noticeable and they're not. And by we, I mean me. So because I already have my brows done, I go around the edges and just make sure it's not crazy. So this was just one coat done. That's like a very light coat. It's not crazy. Blend it down the chin and all that stuff, and I'm good to go. This is not like a very full coverage makeup look. Like, I'm not going in with as much product as I could. Also, this hyperpigmentation mark is so dark. So like, nothing is gonna cover that. And I'm aware of that because like, it's just a very dark one, and that's okay. I mean, we're all human. We all have hyperpigmentation. I don't wanna like fully mask my face. Like, that's never my style. I'd rather just like kind of tone like the darkness down, really. That's it. I'm not trying to do anything crazy. So then I'm gonna go under my eyes with this. This is a really good concealer product. And what I do is I let it sit for a few seconds. So I'm gonna let it sit and then I'm gonna blend it out with my fingers. Okay, blending time, folks. So I'm just gonna go in with my finger and very lightly blend it out. What's your guys' favorite concealer right now? I've been really liking this one, even though it's like a foundation concealer, just because it doesn't crease under the eyes. If you have any suggestions for other, you know, concealers that you feel like I would like or that you want to review on, please let me know, because I would love to start trying some more products. I'm currently testing a bunch of different skin tints, and I got all the products from the brand LYS that just launched at Sephora, but also just launched recently on their own page, and I've been testing those out, so that video is going to come soon. But they don't have a concealer, so just let me know what you think. So now I'm done with that. I'm happy with how my face looks. Sorry if the lighting's a little crazy. I have filmed this video like so many times, and every time the lighting has been wild because the sun is like, it's loud. Great, wonderful. People just out here in the streets making so much damn noise. Right, now that that's all done, I'm gonna move on. I'm not gonna set my face just yet. I'm not setting my under eyes because, like I said before, this product doesn't crease, so I don't need to set it. And the mascara I use doesn't run with this, so it's gonna be good. So I'm gonna go on with bronzer next. This is the Arrive Beauty bronzer, and this is the shade Tan Dark. I really like this. The only downside, really, to be honest, is the fact that the shade range is like crap. There's no other like way to say it. It's like you gotta start being more inclusive with your shades. But I really do like this. I hope they expand their shade range. If you're looking for a bronzer that has like a true like deep dark bronzer that will work on super dark complexions, then the Tarte Beauty the cream one that they have, I've done a review on that one on this channel too. That one is really good, and they have a beautiful dark shade. I use the lightest shade in that one, just so that you have reference. So the lightest shade works for my complexion, and then there's two other ones, and they kind of have like a true like a dark and then like a true deep. It's really nice. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with this bronzer and I'm just gonna bronze up my face and like do the edges and all of that. I'm not gonna go crazy. I'm not contouring or anything like that. This is my everyday kind of makeup look. And I just kind of pile it on, and then I take a little bit on the edge here, not to make my jaw look skinnier or anything like that. It's really just so that it blends really nicely, because again, everyone's face has dimension and you kind of need it to just look more natural. So kind of just do that and blend it out. And then if I feel like I've applied too much bronzer, I can always go over with powder and kind of tone it down. Because sometimes when you're applying bronzer, it feels like you're applying the right amount, and then it's like, yikes. That's kind of what happens with blush too. So next I'm actually gonna go in and do my eyes. So I'm gonna go in with the Arrive Beauty bronzer again. And all I like to do with my eyes on a regular basis is either take the blush or bronzer that I'm wearing that day and put it in the crease. So that's what I'm gonna do, and just blend her out and get like dimension. You know what I mean? Like get some good dimension. That just adds like a nice little something something. And then I like to blend the edge out with my finger. It's just better that way. I don't get the right blend when I use a brush when I do the edges. I like it to be very diffused when I'm doing like a bronzer or a blush. And then I'm gonna take a smaller brush and I'm just gonna go under my lower lash line to add a little bit of smoke to the face, to the eye. Do you guys do this? Do you guys ever pull your bronzer down? I'd love to know. Love to know how you guys like to do your makeup. There's no right or wrong way, obviously. There's literally no wrong way to do makeup. It's just whatever works for you. But I like to do this. It adds a little bit of dimension to the face. I feel like that is like sometimes can get lost. So I apply a little bit of this. Sometimes if I like want to add more smokiness, which is, it's not the look today, I will add like a darker brown color or like a mix of brown and a black together and kind of smoke that out on the edges too, and like create a like seamless kind of gradient of color. Okay, next I'm gonna go on with eyeliner, and this is the Thrive Beauty eyeliner. This is their waterproof, and I use the black color. I think they have like a million shades of that, and I'm just going to line my lid. I don't go all the way down. I just kind of do like maybe 3/4 of the way, and then I take my finger and I blend it out with my finger and kind of diffuse that line out. the more you blend, the like less dark it gets. So like you kind of just blend till you get to like a place that you like. And I like this because it gives me like a nice like smoky line, but it isn't like so much that it's like, whoa, Nelly, what is she doing? You know what I mean? Like, not that you can't do a smoky eye during the day. Girl, do whatever you need. Do whatever you need, whatever you need. However, sometimes it's just a little bit much, especially going into like warmer months that I pray are coming, warmer months, because I am done with winter this year. I am done with winter, and I think most of us are done with winter. So I'm gonna just keep adding until I get the like smoke that I want. And I'm happy with that, that's good. I didn't apply a lot at all. I just kind of kept blending and blending until it had like the right consistency that I wanted. Now, if you apply too much and you're like, oh no, that's too smoky, you can always go in with like your bronzer again, or even just your powder, and go over that line and tone it down. And that's like a really easy way to do that, or at least that's like a way I found. So that's like the eyes done. I'm gonna go in now with mascara. I'm not gonna set my under eyes like I said. So actually no, I'm not gonna go in with mascara. Scratch that. Okay, never mind, I'm not doing that. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna do my cheeks next. So I'm gonna go in with a blush. These are some of my favorite blushes. These are the Ilia Color Hazes, and this is in the shade Stutter. This is gorgeous. This is gorgeous terracotta color. I know that these are a little bit pricey, so if you want like a good alternative to this, like a good like terracotta-y pretty color on the cheeks, I would go with the Jason Wu Hot Fluff. Yeah, Hot Fluff in Cannoli. That's a beautiful shade. And then I also have the shade Waking Up. I feel like with my sweater, Waking Up would be cute. So that's what we're gonna do today. And we're gonna pray that I don't apply too much. However, I'm probably gonna apply too much. Every single time. Every time I apply blush, I apply too much. But because it's cream, it's fine, because it ends up fading a little bit. But this one lasts a really long time. If you are having issues with like masks and blush, this is a good one to try out. Ooh, I feel like I applied too much. So I'm gonna take the Sephora, what is this, 93 blush brush. I really like this. This is the slanted one, and I'm just gonna blend it out. Yikes, 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 yikes. Oh, actually, that's not that bad. I literally panicked. I was like, yikes, okay. That's okay, I think that actually looks really nice. I actually might need to apply a little bit more. All right, I'm gonna take whatever's left on this little like metal thing, and then just apply more. And usually once I do my first application, I apply the rest of the blush if I'm like, oh, I want more pigmentation, towards the back. I'm not applying it to the front of the face. I know a lot of people like to do that, but to me, on me, it just looks a little bit cray cray. I have to be honest. Okay. I feel like now I applied too much. See, I applied too much. I definitely applied too much. As I'm thinking like, oh no, I got this. I don't got this. But that's okay. So that's good and blended. I'm gonna go over the top with it really quick with another clean brush. So this is the Sephora Pro Blush Brush in 99. Jesus. the brush name is just 99, the number 99. I'm gonna apply more on this cheek now. Okay, good. I'm not like pressing too hard. So I'm not like over applying, I don't think, on this side. Luckily with blush, like if you really feel like you apply too much, you just take your powder that you're wearing or your foundation brush that has like leftover product and just like go over the top, and then you're fine. All right, let's see. Do we feel like that's even? I feel like that's good. Maybe a touch more on this side. You know what? And see. And see, this is what's gonna happen. I'm gonna end up, yeah. I feel like that's, yeah. I feel like I messed that up for sure. Okay, that's all right. I'm gonna blend. Okay, I feel like that looks really good, and I'm happy with that. I'm just gonna go close up with this mirror. Yeah, I'm happy with that. I feel like that looks really nice and rosy, but it's not over the top. Usually when I film, if I film and I'm wearing blush, sometimes I apply a little bit more, just because like there's lights and all that stuff. But in general, this is the amount that I would apply for like my everyday and be like very happy with that. And I like to make sure it like blends into the bronzer. So I will just make sure it like kind of blends back and all that. And everyone, the way you apply your blush, like the way, the place that you put it really depends on your face shape. So if you want a more contoured look, kind of do it a little bit higher up and further back. Really depends on your face shape and your preference. There's no right and wrong, like I said. Okay, I have two powders in front of me here. I'm gonna powder my face before I do mascara. All right, I'm gonna go with this one. So this is the Kosas, the new cloud set ones. I've been testing this out and I'm just gonna set my T zone, my chin, mustache area, and then just this like little corner right here. Not under the eyes or on the blush, just that corner. I feel like that gets hella greasy. Okay, I feel good with that. Oh, also, I meant to mention what was on my nails because I feel like I'm gonna get questions on this. So this, I've been wearing bright colors on my body and on my nails just in hopes, in prayers. Prayers that spring comes. And the shade I'm actually wearing, I have in front of me here, is a new shade from Olive & June, and this is the shade Lava, and it's so pretty and bright and summery, and just, it's giving me all the spring feels that I need, because I need them. I'm on the brink. Okay, let's go on to mascara. So I have two mascaras in front of me here. I have my tried and true fave, love of life, the Ilia one, like can't stop, won't stop using it. Will never stop using it. And then I have a new favorite, the Merit Beauty one. I think I'm gonna go with this, just so you guys can see what it looks like, because I feel like I always wear the Ilia one, but I haven't worn the Merit Beauty one that much on camera, only a couple times. So I'm gonna apply it. I'm gonna really try to not make the mascara mouth face, where you're just like, look like a gaping fish with your mouth open. I'm gonna do my best here, but you know, who knows. So that's what one coat looks like. I'm gonna get so you can kind of see. It's cute. She's cute, you guys. I know she's cute. So this is like a tubing mascara, so it doesn't really run. Which, oh my god, I already got mascara all over my lid. What else is new? I always get mascara on my lid. Like, it's, there's no, like, there's never a time. There's never been one time in my entire existence that, like, I haven't. I just, it's the worst. But I'm gonna wait for it to dry and then I'm gonna take a spoolie and scratch it off with that. And I'm gonna do two coats of mascara because this feels like a two-coater kind of day. Okay, that's cute. So I'm gonna do my lower lashes now because I'm in a lower lash kind of mode. So I'm gonna just take this mirror and apply with my lower lashes and hopefully stop talking so I don't get mascara everywhere and accidentally blink. Because is there anything worse than doing that as I'm speaking? Of course, I'm saying that and I'm saying I shouldn't be talking and I'm talking while I'm doing it, so. Did it, I didn't get mascara everywhere. I have a little bit under here, but that isn't from talking. Actually, it's probably from talking. What am I talking about? It's definitely from talking, but it looks pretty good. I am clearly a wizard at mascara. I'm very proud of myself. That looks good. I'm very happy with how my makeup is turning out right now. And then last but not least, we're gonna do lips. The lips on a regular basis, I either just don't like do lip liner or and just slap a lipstick on just for like every day on my couch, whatever, but I do like to wear lip stuff, or I'll just go on with just a lip liner and no lipstick on top. That's kind of like where I go. It's like if I apply too many products, it's just like it's too much. But if I'm going out, dinner, whatever it is, I'm, you know, out in the world more, then I will wear, you know, maybe both. But this is a new lip liner for this channel. This is the Victoria Beckham lip liner, and this is in the shade, which one is this? I have multiple of these. I think this is a shade 04. Yeah, this is the shade 04, and I really like this. And this is really, really good. If you are a fan of Charlotte Tilbury Hot Gossip, or you're a person that likes Charlotte Tilbury Hot Gossip, but you feel like it's a little bit too pink sometimes, this is a really nice alternative for my ladies of color out there. My ladies and gentlemen of color who like lip liners. This is a good, like, pinky brown. And it doesn't get like too crazy. So I like to apply it and then I like to take my finger and kind of pat it out. I like a more diffused lip line. So that's what I like to do, is like make sure my lip, like the line is diffused. Now I don't overline my lips. However, if you are the type of person that likes to do that, these lip liners would be good for that. And they have like a brownie color. They have like a more brownie color that's similar to Hot Cocoa from Marc Jacobs. Oh my god, can I think? And then they have like a true deep one. And then they have a bunch of other like lighter neutrally colors. And then they also have a red. And everything is gonna be linked down below so you can shop, and I'll give all the names of colors because I feel like I didn't do a very good job of giving all the names of everything I used. But yeah, that's it for today. This is my makeup. I'm really happy with it. This is just like my everyday look, my easy peasy lemon squeezy. Like this would only take me 10 minutes. If I wasn't talking and blabbing on and having no chill, like this would be my like 10 minute makeup face and I would be done. Everything blends really easily. Everything is like super simple to use. It doesn't look cakey. It doesn't look over the top, but it does look like you're wearing a little bit of makeup. This isn't necessarily a true no makeup makeup look because I'm definitely like smoked out. Oh, I didn't even remove the rest of my, please hold. I didn't remove the rest of the makeup that I have everywhere. So I just take a spoolie and I go like this and just remove anywhere that there is a little bit of, okay. Back to the regularly scheduled programming. This definitely has a little bit of smoke to it, but you can definitely use all these products to create a no makeup makeup look. And yeah, that's it for today. I would love to know, what order do you do your makeup in? Do you do your brows first? I'd love to know. That's something that interests me. Do you do your brows first? But yeah, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. It was really fun to do. I like doing my makeup on camera and talking to you guys. So yeah, that's it. Thank you again. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.